Welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera, Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We've been messing around with this thing over here, looking into various areas, supposedly with this
Ready.
Holographic control interface. We can go to a few other areas. Now this is the Meal of Est. That's where we're ultimately heading to with the main quest. And Coln Village we're going to go to, all these other areas we've been to. We can go to other times in these areas as well, but first I want to check out Coln Village. I'm assuming we can go there. Destination not recognized. Huh. Alright, I don't want to go to Meal of Est now. Right, not yet. It might not be recognized either, but that's not the way. I want to take Master Renios, I think is his name. I want to take his airship over there. So oh, toggle the controls between space and time. I want to make sure we're going through time. See, that didn't work. Temporal network connections limited. Please repair the network. Okay. Repair the network by using the crystal lattice. Okay. I remember seeing this. Oh. Again, the map lights up and changes colors. The lines between each point grow and fade. Some of them grow solid and then disappear. Others have gaps in them that never light up at all. After several minutes, the activity ceases and the voice speaks to you again. Could not restore network. Temporal connections have deteriorated beyond repair. Please consult your system conservator immediately. You can't raise the shield again like in your memory, but the network once had another purpose, you remember. In the memory, you used the tesseract to shift the controls from time to space. Perhaps if you shifted it back. Well, I know the space one. In essence, this is like a quick travel then. So we can't go. I'm a little disappointed. We can't go back in time and look at these areas in a different time, because that would be awesome. So this probably won't work anyway. Meal of Est. Destination not recognized. Okay. So apparently we can't go to anywhere we haven't been. We can see where we haven't been.
All right.
But not go there. And the Bloom, Crefton, and Caravia sound were not listed in this tesseract either, so. Wow, well, disappointing then. So we are in Caravanserai. Can I go to Caravanserai from Caravanserai? That's what I want. know. Because I need to talk to Mr. Renio then. Cave of Last Words. Government Square. Well, we could come up from Cliff's Edge. Eh. Six of one, half dozen of another. So, yeah, let's go to Cliff's Edge then. It's an easy way to get to where I want to go, which is to talk to Mr. Renio. I'll see in a minute if I actually have his name correctly. Well, that was disappointing. I thought we were going to go exploring through that device. Nope. Not really. Not yet, anyway. Okay, so up here is Caravanserai.
Absolutely
up there. So he is up here. Master Renio, I got it right. Cool. Hail. He turns from his observation of the laborers and asks, "How may I assist you?" "I need to fly to the Valley of Dead Heroes." "Excellent timing," he says, bowing. "My vessel will be departing shortly. Board at your leisure." He leans in closer. "I should also warn you that we won't be able to retrieve you from the valley. We never tarry there. Its energies are not good for our ship's engines. Maybe I should rest first, then. Since there's no way back, there may be dangers. Damn it. I should have gone there first. It's so cool to see this now instead of that dome. So, I'm so used to clicking on the map. By the time I get used to not doing it, I'll be done with the game. So unfortunately, the bad thing about traveling to Caravanserai is that you end up on this little island which you can't get off of except other than to go somewhere else. Or jump off there. Alright. "Have you completed your business in the city? Say the word and we will leave port." "I'm ready. Let's depart." "Very well, my friend. We will be on our way momentarily." Who's running up? "You two Levies, you have been temporarily reassigned. Come with me." What the hell's going on? People coming. Riss. A group of tough-looking thugs approach from behind you. Leading them is Riss, who gives Tybeer a mocking salute. "Hello, Tybeer. Living town? My friends and I would like the money you owe us first." Tybeer takes an involuntary step back and addresses the thugs. "I don't know what Riss has told you, but I promise you, I was never paid for the job. I don't have any money, and beating me won't change that." He thinks, "At least I don't have enough money. Not to sate him. This is trouble." Riss says, "Don't believe him, Helpmeets. He's never spoken the truth in his life." Tybeer turns to you, pleading, "Lass, please. I'm all out of tricks. Say something. Get me out of this." Intimidation, which I'm not good at. Captain Tiber is under my protection. Do you want to face the wrath of the changing god? I went to go sleep so that I would have all my points, you know? Success. Riss sneers and looks back at his companions. She's not the changing god. The changing god is 10 feet tall and... He pauses to see the others backing up and slinking away. Hey, where are you going? I'm telling you, she's not the changing god. They beat a hasty retreat and Riss chases after them. Cool. Bye. What do you say? Come back here or something.
Thanks for intervening back there. Riss and his friends caught me unawares. Me, of all people.
Huh. I'm not sure I should have intervened. You took advantage of the boy. Indigo. Nonsense. Well, mostly nonsense. But I didn't have to go back for him. And I did. He folds his arms. Gratitude is a lost art for some, but not for me. You have my thanks. It's up to you what you do with it. Mr. Renio says, as I was saying, we should be on our way. He looks nervously around. I hope you have no other surprises for me. All here, then? The wind is right for us. Let's sail, friends. He begins shouting commands to his crew, and they cast off the mooring lines. The airship pushes away from the spire, and the city of your birth falls away below you. It's moving! Cool. Check that out. A little scary looking.
Updated my journal.
Or my logbook. People are coming. Hello? I can't zoom in or do anything. Quest failed. A call to war? Quest failed. Quest failed, wayward daughter. I thought I finished wayward daughter. What? Even as he stalks towards you, for a moment it appears as if the man is unaware of your presence. He stops in front of you. Rocking ever so gently, he stares right through you, murmuring under his breath. Chanting or insane rambling? You draw closer and notice the scars he bears upon his face. Then his gaze matches yours, and he suddenly grows silent. He sees you now. His eyes flicker across your face and pause on your tattoo. He thinks, she bears the tattoo of an Ifr and a Dendra father. Good or bad, we shall have to test her. I hope there's something in my journal about why I fail. Wayward daughter. It's the one having to do with loss of self and the other women, right? Didn't I finish that? Call to arms. Oh, I didn't... Yeah, I know what call to arms is. The people in the bar. The pub. The, club. Whatever the hell it is. I was supposed to, yeah. I didn't have... I was supposed to, you know, bring them forth so they could... all join the war effort for, what's her name? I don't remember these people's names. But, I could only do it with two or three of them. The other wouldn't because of some issue he had. Some kind of magical malady or something like that, and I was telling him he should take a... I was gonna tell him he should take his eye out or something. I didn't want to do that. So, yeah. He bows. His name is Klin'Kar. His movements stiff and halting. Then with blinding speed, his hand snakes out and brushes a speck of dust from your shirt. The hand is gone before you can react. I'm Klin'Kar, and these are my associates. You are in the Valley of Dead Heroes. His jagged smile is rimmed with blood. Two memorialists have escaped us. You will find them. We need them. Yeah, just attack. No, I don't think so. Die. Why do you want to find them? He hisses out a long exhalation of breath. We must open the endless gate. Find the missing memorialists. But why must you open the endless gate? He smiles beatifically, exposing his bloody gums. Nice. It is what we are called to do. And who are we to disobey the call when it comes? He thinks it is power. Power unending. Are you children of the Endless Gate? Do you know Kiyotawa from Sega's Cliffs? He looks at you suspiciously. I am not familiar with her, though one of the brethren did come to us recently from Sega's Cliffs. Perhaps Motley will know. You can inquire of him in the necropolis, as soon as you find our missing friends. I guess I'll help him. I don't see any reason to be so brash as this. And nor do I want to sacrifice myself. What do they want them for? They have escaped. But should they have escaped, or no? Should they be free? I don't know. Very well, I'll help you find them. Without more information, I really can't come up with a good reason to do this, or this. So, I'll agree for now, at least. He is holding up his finger, as if to threaten you for not complying, and then realizes what you've said. Oh. Then we would be glad of your assistance. The memorialists are somewhere nearby. We can smell them. Go find them and bring them to us. I pray to the gate for your success. Huh. I can talk to them now. Find the memorialist or taste liberation's blade. I don't kind of like the tone of your voice there. Find our memorialist friends. Bring them to account. Have you found them yet? Have you? Oh, I haven't moved from where I'm standing. The only time you waste is yours. Find them. Okay, well first I'm gonna look around and stuff. These mooring posts are used or to keep ships from drifting off, or at least they were back when ships used to stop here. We can interact with all this crap. Wooden slats have been cobbled with ancient machine parts to create makeshift cargo pads. Though still functioning, they look like they've been cast aside and neglected.
Of course.
We got loot. Well, it's loud. I'm gonna decrease down my phone volume here. Shouldn't be that loud. Sorry, guys. Okay. I got 18 shins, and we'll gladly take.
Ready.
You pull the planks back. A crawl space extends behind them, with two small alcoves recessing the walls. They are remnants of grave markers and memorials from ancient times. One seems shallow. The other has been blocked by rubble falling from above. Both of them appear to have been built to hold bodies, but neither are occupied. Yet, you can see a disturbance in the dust of the crawl space. Someone came by this way, at least. Perhaps they're still here. I sent a disturbance in the force. Let's search more thoroughly to see if anyone's still there. You peer deep into the gloom. The dust has been more than disturbed. You see footprints. After a few minutes, your diligence is rewarded. There is a third alcove at the back of the crawl space, hidden behind a great stone slab. The slab is held up by a stone the size of a human head, creating a small gap hardly half a meter high. You crouch down and peer through the gap. Two people are hiding in the space behind it. Oh, could it be the Memorialists? One of them, a bearded man with a kind expression, whispers to you, "Hold, friend. If friend you be. My name is Beltrax. This is Ronus Kasul. Those damn cultists gave chase to us. Ronus knew of this small sepulcher in which we have hidden, but we have nowhere left to run. They will murder us if you reveal our position." He thinks, "Friend or foe, either way, Ronus shall not sacrifice himself for me." "Please," says Ronus, "Beltrax is but a visitor to this place. He has no part in our struggle with the children. Tell them that we have fled, and that you couldn't find us." "Oh my God, trap them in a sup. That's so evil. Cover your tracks. I'll deal with the cultists." "You have our gratitude. Good luck, friend." They watch you leave. Gold tide raised a moderate amount. Okay. Don't see how they couldn't have seen that. We get interact with this too. Oh, there's all these things. Oh, cool. What about this one? Oh, I want to see in my journal.
Wow.
These the only quests we have now. A call to war. I've left Sega's cliffs behind me, and I don't know when I'll win or if I'll return. There's some typos here. Clarion will have to finish her recruiting efforts herself. Alright, Leto. Right, the words of Kra. And I didn't have a good option. It was going to end in his pain or death or something. So that we've done. Rin's free. Just making these go away. Wayward daughter. Oh, that's because she's not there. I handled Loss of Self's problem, but didn't have the opportunity to speak with Mother Tamaz before leaving Sega's cliffs. Yeah, she fell down with the remnants of her home. So I couldn't complete that. Oh well. Alright, so that's where we've been. We've got this one.
On it.
Want it. You move the planks aside and get nothing more than a splinter for your trouble. The unmarked cliff wall is all that you see. Is that a hit point? What about this one?
Let's go.
Ooh, experience. Peering behind the sheetrock, you see only a faint etching in the stone, almost worn away by the passage of the years. It reads, "Sanity slipping. The tombs will hold my salvation." Oh. Is that the same O that we found in the Fifth Eye Tavern? Dunno.
All right.
Apart from the old etching, you find nothing else. You find only the cliff wall again. No amount of investigation reveals anything else. Alright. Let's go interact with this thing then.
I am the very soul of action.
Yes. Mess with the thingy majingy. Oh, that's we can't interact with that. Let's just examine. What about this?
Of course.
The alcove is vacant. It's only inhabited the blowing dust of the valley. Though it appears to have been built to hold bodies, it is curiously empty. The only inhabitant of this alcove is the blowing dust. You peer into this alcove. It's deep enough to hide people, but it is strangely empty. After a thorough investigation, you step away. So, these three people, why couldn't they find these people?
Yes.
You check the empty alcove thoroughly for hidden doors or panels, but your investigation reveals nothing. You see faint traces of footprints in the dust. Closer examination reveals that someone must have stopped in front of this alcove for a moment. Your investigation turns up no signs of any hidden compartments.
Fine.
Find nothing here. Will they not let us go?
Don't mind if I...
Yeah. Where do you think you're going? There are only two ways out of here. The first is to find those memorialists. The second... He licks his lips. Well, you won't like the second, but you'll discover it immediately if you try to get past us again. Are you sure they're here? What if they slip by you? They did not, and neither will you. Gonna lie. Is that a persuasion check? I can't find them. And I'm done looking for them. He smiles his bloody smile. You will bring them here. You will. I think I'm better at persuasion than intimidation or deception. I like this one, though. That's kind of badass. Well, for someone who's very convinced that they're here, you really don't want to look for them. Were you aware that... Yeah, I'm not going to choose this because he knows they're here, apparently. He, like, knows with certainty. Doesn't make sense why they don't just go get him. I mean, really? You're gonna not try to find two people, but instead you're gonna fight four people. Were you not aware that I have reinforcements? I will call them if I must. Fail? Haha. Guess we're gonna fight. Then call them. Call them and watch as we tear your spirit from its carnal cage. I will flay the skin from your muscles, the muscles from your bones, and free your light into the endless gate. Uh-huh. Dark barrier. Tiber! Well, I say go after the big guy first. I think I leveled up his sucker punch. What's this? Unstable detonation. Yeah, do that. Nice. Okay, so we're still on Tiber, right? Yes, we are. I just realized we can tell from that. So I'm gonna pass this turn. Eretus! Oh, what are you doing all the way over there? He's always weird like that. Opportunist. sucker punch. Oh, with his quick ice axe? Cool.
I bet your ancestors felt that.
Cool. See us. Claim us. Did we... Okay, he must have buffed him up or something. Which is fine, because we're going after Klin'Kar right now. It's my turn. It's my turn! Onslaught, eh? Or flash. Let's do flash. Boom.
What do you think of this?
Haha. He's not thinking much of anything anymore. Calistige. Yeah, throw another flash on the fire. They're both, like, almost dead. Awesome. He's running. Oh, nope. What's going on there? What's that? Is that supposed to happen? Tiber, huh? Can't do it. What about this hook thing? Oh, nice. He's flanked. Cool.
No hard feelings.
Nice. He can do that and attack. I love it.
Back! Victorious!
Yay!